What are you doing on YouTube? You need to read a book. But in all seriousness, there are a million different ways to learn about something. YouTube is just one of those ways, but reading a book is oftentimes the best way for a lot of people. So today I'm going to talk to you about my favorite books that I recommend if you want to learn more about home brewing or learn more about the brewing science in general and a bunch of other different cool topics. If it's your first time here, thanks for checking out my channel. I typically will do either a grain to glass video or I'll do a different video on various homebrewing topics like the one you're watching right now. If you like either of those things, please go ahead and hit that like button and hit the subscribe button as well so you get to see more of this stuff in the future. If at any point in time you find yourself interested in checking out one of these books, I've linked them all in the description box down below. The first book I'm going to recommend, if you have spent more than 5 minutes in homebrewing, you probably know about this book. It is How to Brew by John Palmer. John Palmer is one of the original pioneers of homebrewing, along with Charlie Papazian, and he wrote this book a long time ago, actually. So kind of comes with a caveat that take it in reference with the times it was written in. A lot of the information in that book may come across as the word of God, but it is not necessarily so. A lot of processes have changed, a lot of ingredients have changed over time, and a lot of the information that's in that book is a little outdated, but it is still one of the single best references for starting out brewing. John Palmer covers pretty much every single angle in how you're gonna start brewing, what is brewing, how does it work, how do people do it on the pro scale versus how do they do it on the home scale. He also covers every single method of it in the book, from extract to brew in a bag to three vessel all grain, however you wanna cut that cake. He covers it in that book, which is why I recommend it. It is not a book that I personally own. It's actually available for free on the internet out there as howtobrew.com. I would once again recommend maybe pairing this with a more modern brewing techniques book once you get the hang of it, but if you're just starting out brewing, this is definitely a good read and well worth your time. The second book I highly recommend is this one, Brewing Classic Styles by Jamil Zanishev. If John Palmer's How to Brew taught me how to get started and inspired me to get going in home brewing, this book taught me how to actually make the beer and how to design recipes. I've brewed nearly every single recipe in this book. That's kind of how I got the experience to actually start making my own recipes. Jamil Zanishev is a very, very successful home brewer who is actually a pro brewer now. So when he wrote this book, he basically compiled together a bunch of medal-winning recipes for almost every style of beer. It's not every single BJCP style, but it's most of them. This is not just a list of recipes, though. It is a style description book as well. So it's a good companion to the BJCP guidelines. It kind of puts them in more of layman's terms as well. It also offers recipes for both extract and all-grain versions of the same beer. And a couple of those styles also have like one or two different versions of recipes for them, which is quite nice. I can confirm that the beer you're gonna make by using this book is going to be delicious, and it's well worth it. The next one on my list is this one, Brew Like a Monk by Stan Hieronymus. If you at all are interested in Belgian beers and specifically in Trappist beers, this is the book for you. Many of the Belgian breweries are very secretive. They hold their cards close to their chest when it comes to disclosing any information about how they make their beers. But a lot of that information is actually contained in this book in some way, shape, or form. The author traveled to many Belgian breweries as well as Belgian-themed breweries here in the States. And got a whole bunch of compiled techniques, ingredients, and just a whole bunch of really very useful information for when it comes to brewing those beers. There's also plenty of good recipes in this book as well if you want to just kind of take one and take a stab at brewing, I don't know, a Belgian quad the way Chimay does. There's a lot of really interesting information in here, and it's well worth your time. It's a little dense, but it overall is a very good book for increasing your knowledge of a specific and little understood subset of brewing. The next book I recommend is this one, IPA. Plain and simple, that's what it's about. The book is written by Mitch Steele, who is the former brewmaster at Stone Brewing Company. This book here is well worth your time if you are at least remotely interested in IPAs. Not only does it give you the history of them, but it also gives you a lot of good recipes and brewing techniques you're gonna need if you're trying to brew one. They can be a little tricky sometimes, and a lot of stuff that's mystery to some home brewers, like hop combinations and water profiles and things like that, are really covered and broken down in this book very well. It's something that's definitely worth your time. This is a little bit more geared, though, towards the West Coast IPA, the older school kind of IPAs of the mid-2000s. The final book I'm gonna recommend is actually not a single book. It is actually a series of books. It is this series, the Malt, Water, Hops, Yeast, Brewing Elements series This is a deep dive. If you're looking at starting out brewing, I would not go right into these books at all. I would start with How to Brew or The Complete Joy of Home Brewing and that sort of thing. But these books right here are going to go hardcore into the science. So if you're a complete nerd like me and you want to find out what goes on under the hood, these are the books to read. They are going to read a little bit like textbooks. They are really pretty dense, but they're written by extremely knowledgeable people, and they really have a lot to offer if you have the time and patience for it. Many of the people that wrote these books also wrote other books that are on this list. You have Jamel Zinashev, who wrote the yeast book, in addition with Chris White, that White from White Labs, yeah. You also got John Palmer and Stan Hieronymus writing these books as well. They're very knowledgeable authors. And like I said, it's just well worth your read if you got the time and the patience for it. I'm gonna include three other books here, but I'm gonna consider these more of like honorable mentions, I guess. So if you're looking for techniques on modern, hazy, New England style IPAs, you might wanna actually look at the new IPA by Scott Janisch. Now, Scott Janisch is another IPA guru out there. I've brewed one of his recipes before, actually. And he has a different take on the whole thing that brings in more modern and science-based understanding of hops and how they work in modern IPAs, like hazy IPAs. And if you wanna know more things about like terpenes and biotransformation and stuff like that, it's definitely a good book to read on those subjects. The second one is a companion book to How to Brew, and that is The Complete Joy of Home Brewing by Charlie Papazian. He's the other father of home brewing. Essentially the same thing as How to Brew with a little bit kind of a different take on it. The same caveats apply as well. Just be sure you take this in reference to the time that it was written, and don't be afraid to challenge some of the concepts that are in here. It is definitely well worth your read, though. It is a great introduction to brewing, and it does get you a lot of the core information that you need to start understanding how brewing works, and especially to understand how the processes work. The final honorable mention here is actually just a recipe book. This is Mashmaker by Michael Dawson, that Michael Dawson of Brewing TV. This is a great recipe book that has some really, really interesting twists on standard brews. So what I like about this book is that it is not actually just another recipe book. These are a bunch of classic styles, but they've all got a twist on them. They're all really a little bit different. So we've got things like a pale Doppelbach, a smoked wheat beer, a Rauchweizen. We have a Dawson Y. Weihnachtsdoppelweizenbach. I'm not quite sure what that is, but it sounds like some kind of Weizenbach. You're looking at some really interesting kind of adjunct ingredients here, like honey and hibiscus and orange blossom and a bunch of other stuff. So it's definitely a good book to read, to use for your own recipe library, if you could find it. Like I said, I don't know if it's still in print. I had to scour the internet to find a copy of this. It's a very useful resource in terms of developing your own recipes as well. So comment down below if you like the books that I recommend, if you agree, disagree, whatever. What's your favorite homebrewing book of choice? As always, don't be afraid to hit that like button. It doesn't bite. And feel free to subscribe if you want more content like this. If you want to support the channel, please go ahead, check out my merchandise store down below in the description box. Also, if you want to support the channel on a more personal basis, I also have a Patreon, which is linked in the description box. Thank you very much to my current Patreon supporters. You guys are killing it right now. You're helping me out a lot. Also, in the description box, I have an Amazon store, which is where you can find a whole bunch of different equipment and recommended things that I've worked with in the past and I do actually recommend. So every single piece of equipment on that store is something that I personally endorse. If you want to follow me on more than just YouTube, I'm also on Instagram as The Apartment Brewer, where you'll see slightly more frequent content updates as well. If you're still here, I really do appreciate it because the watch time does matter quite a bit. And that's awesome. You guys really are my biggest fans and I appreciate you. So here's to you, and I'll catch you guys in the next one. So until then, cheers.